two in a row.
Actually devastating. At least someone knows how to get a job.
Hello guys, Mukas here. The Max Spam algorithm is going away.
Max Spam! Max Spam!
So in a recent PTS patch notes, the devs have announced that the maximum pressure alert and the aerial anomaly alert are going away. And I understand this choice because I started seeing some bad side of these alerts on the continent with the free vehicles or the free maxes. But it still got me some crazy epic moments like you're gonna see in the background. So enjoy it while it's there. I have to admit that this alert allowed me to know my max game much better, same for the air game. I never used the Coyote missiles before that, and now I have a good grasp of the post-nerf scatter cannons. I realized that the max can be very strong and very weak at the same time. You can get some insane kill streaks if you manage to get your health back with an engineer, or if you kill other maxes with a salvage implant. It gives you back 500 health, which is huge. So thanks for the farm, RPG. But I'm actually quite glad the max alert is going away because it was creating a lot of stale moments where you couldn't do anything as infantry because everyone was max, and even if you killed one you'd have two coming your way very fast with the very short spawns and the fact that you can pull it again immediately. For the aerial anomaly I have a bit more mixed feelings about the removal because it wasn't impacting the infantry gameplay as much. The update to the anomaly where you had to go get some intel in some locations and bring them back at the anomaly, I think completely killed this alert. It made it too complex for most people. Honestly, I still don't understand it now. And after that change, people completely stopped caring about this alert and started pulling air just to farm. The nice days of this anomaly was when the alert was very simple. Just get in the big circle and survive. This was creating some really epic moments. But now it's mostly people taking advantage of free aircrafts, so I understand why they are removing this alert. At the same time, the bastions are coming, so I still think the air battles are gonna be epic, especially in the middle of the map. And actually, one of the most interesting change that I found in the PTS patch notes is the Empire strength and continent meta. The fact that territory control is always important to get resources. So the faction that has the most territory control will trigger the alert, and the fact that they trigger the alert will get them resources. Here it says, when a meltdown alert triggers, the faction that started the alert will receive an immediate 5x tick of resources from bases they own. This means that territory control is now important all the time, not just after the alert has triggered. So this will motivate the factions to take as much territory as they can before and even after the alert. And you get as much resources for triggering an alert as for winning an alert, 5x tick. So these are very interesting days for Planetside 2. I've seen many players coming back to the game. Yesterday I got killed by Mantis on Miller. Some big outfits are coming back in mass. The fights are still huge on Miller with all this hype. So another change that I found interesting in the PTS patch notes is that Bastion Fleet Carriers will earn resources for its faction if they are hovering in contested territory. And this process takes about 17 minutes for it to work. So the outfits will be motivated to keep their Bastion Fleet Carriers in the hot zones, contested territory, which is gonna make them impact the battlefield much more than if they were just flying away in friendly territory. They have also increased the health of the Bastion Fleet Carrier and added shields to its weak points. It's gonna be much harder to take down. You'll have to focus each weak point to kill it. You cannot just go kamikaze on one point, kill it and die, because they have a shield and they'll just recharge if you don't commit to it. So the hype is real, thanks to all the new guys that joined my outfit recently. It's nice to see fresh blood on the battlefield. Welcome Northlander, welcome Lionzy, welcome Ads. I'm still learning every day playing this game. Yesterday I was running an open squad and the member managed to get the Thunderer on A point in a tech plant. I was shocked when I saw that, and the way that he managed to get it up there was the most surprising. It was with tank mines. You can make your Sanji fly with tank mines if he has mine guard. So anyway, I'll try to make a video out of this and keep up the good content guys and the good IDs. Even in weekdays there is huge queues to get in the big continents. And I can see this becoming a problem when a lot of new players are gonna come and when the servers are gonna be packed. So I hope they'll find a solution to this. make the player caps bigger, or add a new continent. This will be great. Usher, anyone? Anyway, guys, Escalation is coming. Brace yourselves. Be ready for Star Wars in Planetside 2. By the way, one thing I advise you to do, if you want to help this game grow, is leave a positive review on Steam, which is a huge platform for gaming now, and that's how many people discover their games. It's now at 90% positive reviews. Honestly, I think it should be at 99%. It's a free game, it delivers a huge amount of content. You can make friends, you can find love in it. Some people say it's gonna make it pop in the trending category. Right now with 90%, we already made it to the top rated category on Steam, which is huge. And if we arrive at 95% positive reviews, it will put it in the overwhelmingly positive reviews category on Steam, which will make it much more visible for a lot of new people. So guys, leave a stream review, tell your crazy stories about this game, how you got max crashed by 2500 people and survived somehow. We can already see the impact of increasing population just from the hype of the Escalation update, which was basically one live stream. Imagine if Planetside 2 was in the front page of Steam as a free-to-play game that anyone can try. I think the servers would explode. Good luck, RPG. So guys, let's piece off RPG and make the servers explode. Have a good day, guys. Stay epic. Bye-bye.
dominating like a true 6-4.